progressive leadership. A leader.
I present to this convention for the office of President of these United States, one who is endowed with the intellectual boldness of Thomas Jefferson, the indomitable courage of Andrew Jackson, the faith and patience of Abraham Lincoln, the rugged integrity of Grover Cleveland, and the scholarly vision of Woodrow Wilson, Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Indicated to you why I accept the nomination which you have offered me, in spite of my desire to retire to the quiet of private life. You and this convention are to build our safer economy for the future. I am speaking to you now from the train before us in 1944. First, to win the war. Secondly, to form worldwide international organizations and to arrange to use the armed forces of the sovereign nations of the world to make another world war. In these days of global warfare, I shall not be able to find the time in the world to come. They will also decide, these people of ours, to realize the ideals which we seek. In the last three elections, and third, to build an economy for our returning veterans, and this worldwide job to inexperienced or immature hands, to those who oppose land lease and international cooperation against the forces of aggression and tyranny, until they could read the polls. At that time was considered only as the provider of human chattels, terms which the human mind cannot improve. With sneers. But for example, before our entry into CES, to those who by international conferences and united actions have begun to build that kind of common understanding and cooperative experience which will be so necessary in the world to come.
The delegate, the Honorable Keene Johnson.
Harry S. Truman as his running mate. The vice presidential nominee received the crowd's approval at the convention, none dreaming what the near future held for the former senator.
All right. There you go.
The campaign with the man he most admired.